transfer this to the United States as well. Now, you invited Mr. Bannon to come and talk to your students in Chicago. Now, I imagine most of your students are free traders, globalists. I guess they're not from the heartland of America as well. You brought Mr. Bannon in to explain to them why, I guess, people had a backlash against their way of thinking, yeah?
So first of all, to clarify, I invited him to debate with one of our faculty, in particular with Austin Gosby. Mm. So it's not like a speech by itself. It's more like a confrontation, because I think that whether you like him or not, Steve Bannon was able to intercept a lot of this resentment. And the solution that he proposes are solutions that I don't particularly like, but we cannot ignore them. I think that, and in a sense, we are giving him a gift by isolating him and making it like a pariah, because in this current environment, being a pariah against the establishment is a badge of honor, not sort of something that is negative. In fact, the center I ran at Chicago, the Stigler Center, co-organized with Harvard Law School a conference last fall called Populist Plutocrats, A Lesson from Abroad, where we compare all the populist plutocrats from Berlusconi to Taksim to Estrada in the Philippines, etc. And there is one element in common of all these guys, and of course the big elephant in the room was Trump, but there is one point in element in common is the fact that when the establishment start to pile up in a situation in which the establishment is not credible, the more you pile up, the more people like him. In general, it's a him. And I think that that's a lesson we have to really take at heart, that piling up is not a solution to defeat this kind of populism.
Still watching? Perfect. Click here to watch another great video from CNBC International. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.